Hey everyone. Yesterday, Batiste shared with us a new feature in TypeBot called inline variable formatting. So if you head over to the documentation and go under editor, variables, and then here, you'll notice that there's a new section called inline variable formatting. So down below, you'll see three different examples of what you can do here, but there's just so many different ways to use it because you can use JavaScript in order to manipulate or to format your text bubbles. And what I'd like to do in this video is walk you through the example that Batiste shared with us yesterday. And it's kind of like using a fallback solution within your chatbot flows. So what I mean by that, if you've ever noticed that in your chatbot flow, there's a blank space because a user didn't put an input in the variable, or maybe you just didn't pass in a value for a variable, then you'll get an awkward space or an awkward blank within where the variable is supposed to show up. So in this case, it's useful to create a fallback solution by using one of these inline variable formatting techniques. So what I'd like to do here is walk you through an example of what that looks like. So this is the notation that we use in TypeBot. So you'll notice that we have to include the equal sign here in both cases, or right before those two curly braces. And then we bring in the JavaScript code that we want to execute. So if we run this code, I want to share with you an example or a conflict that I came across, and it looks like this. So here, the reason why the JavaScript didn't execute is because I didn't define the variable name. So what I have to do here is actually create it. So I'll put it in here. And now that it's created and TypeBot can recognize it, it can actually execute this code. But before I do that, what I want to do is talk a little bit more about what this is. So this is an if statement expressed as a ternary operator. Now bear with me, because I think this might be useful to many of you. So if you just ask ChatGPT what a ternary operator is in JavaScript, you'll get some sort of answer that looks like this. So what we're doing is we're creating a shorthand version of an if statement where we pass in the condition. And if that condition is true, then we pull in the value of whatever this part of the code brings. And if it's false, then we bring in whatever value that this part of the code returns. So if we head over to TypeBot, you'll notice that the condition is set to the name of the variable. So what we're doing here is just bringing back a true or false value. So if the name variable is not defined, then that's going to bring a false value. If there's something in there, like let's say someone put their name Bob, then it's going to return as true. So whenever this has some sort of value in it, like Bob, then the code is going to bring in the name Bob, because that's the value of the name variable. However, if it's false, then we can bring in whatever value that we want, or whatever sort of like piece of JavaScript that we want. So in most cases, we want to create some sort of fallback solution that works in all cases. So for instance, imagine in an email newsletter, sometimes people put a personalization bit in there where it's like first name. But if there's no first name that exists, then they can put like friend or there or something like that, just to make sure that there's a value in there and that we avoid creating awkward experiences, right? So if we execute this code one more time, you'll notice that it says, hi there. So then that's because the variable name has nothing in it, right? However, if I include a name, and let's save this as the name variable, and let's run through this example one more time. So I'm going to put in my name here, So instead of hi there, it should say hi Nefer. So that's just one example of how you can use these inline variable formatting techniques to make your TypeBot smarter. All right, if you have any questions, shoot them in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.